Thanks to Brilliant for sponsoring this video.
Today I want to show you guys a way that you probably have not thought about before to solve this quartic equation. Unless you have watched my previous video, then you can kind of guess what we are going to do here. And let me tell you, it works. So let's just jump right into it. First off, this equation has no rational solution, so we cannot use the rational zero theorem. Second of all, we can actually factor it as a product of quadratic times quadratic, and I'm not going to do that. You can watch my other video for it, but not here. What we are going to do is the following. Notice we have the x squared term and the x to the first power term. Let me put the x to the fourth with the minus 1 right here together. So we are looking at negative x squared minus 2x minus 1 and then plus x to the fourth power. Of course, that's still equal to 0. X squared, x to the first, just treat it as c and then equal to 0. Yes, we can use the quadratic formula for this. But usually we don't like to have a negative in front of the x squared. It's okay. Let's divide everybody by negative 1. So we are looking at x squared, and this is plus 2x, and then plus 1 minus 4 minus x to the fourth power equal to 0. And here you go. This right here is the c. A is equal to 1, b is 2. Quadratic formula. It tells us x is equal to negative b, which is the 2 here, plus or minus, take the square root, b squared, so we have 2 squared, minus 4a is 1, and then c is all this, which is 1 minus x to the 4th power, and then all divided by 2 times 1. Yes, to be honest, I set this up. This right here simplifies it very, very nicely. So I kind of worked backwards to create this and was so happy about coming up with something that if you use this, it's actually super helpful. All right, so right here, I'm just going to simplify this a little bit. This is just x equals negative 2 plus or minus. Here, if you look at the inside, we get just 4, and then minus 4 times that is minus 4. And then minus 4 times this is plus 4x to the 4th power. So they cancel. And then we just have to take the square root of 4x to the 4th power. And then all over 2. And then we can simplify this a little bit. This right here is, of course, equal to negative 2 plus or minus. Square root of 4 is 2. And then square root of x to the 4th power is x to the 2nd power. Don't worry about absolute value or anything because there's a plus minus here already. And then divide it by 2. And then we can factor out 2 and then cancel things out, right? So let's do that real quick. So cancel this. So we are looking at x equals minus 1 plus or minus x to the 2nd power. Look at that. Finally. Yes, I came up with something that if you use this, it simplifies it very nicely. And now, because we are doing quadratic formulas, so we'll use quadratic formula to solve these two equations. The first one is with the plus. So I'll just say number 1, x equals negative 1 plus x squared. Move the x to the other side, we get x squared and then minus x and then minus 1 equal to 0. Quadratic formula again. Negative negative 1 plus or minus, and then negative 1 squared minus 4. AC, so 1 and negative 1, all over 2 times 1. And I will just do this in your head. Yeah? So this is plus 1, and then plus or minus. This is 1 plus 4, which is 5, instead of the square root. And yes, we get our golden ratio from here. Secondly, let's do it with the minus. So x equals negative 1. This is the minus x squared. Put this 2 to the other side. X squared plus x plus 1 equal to 0. Quadratic formula again. Negative 1 plus or minus square root 1 squared minus 4ac 1 and 1 all over 2 times 1. So x equals negative 1 plus or minus, check this out. 1 minus 4 is negative 3 in the square root. Yeah, negative 3 square root over 2. And this right here, we can get negative 1 plus or minus I square root of 3. In fact, these two are two of the unit of the unity of the cube root of. It's a solution to x to the third power is equal to 1. But anyway, I forgot the unity of something like that. Anyway, that we have two solutions here, and then we have two more right here. So that's it. Now, if you like math as much as I do, then I would like to tell you guys about our sponsor today, Brilliant.work.
Brilliant is the best online learning platform that helps you excel in math and science. They have over thousands of in-depth lessons ranging from basic math to advanced calculus. No matter if you want to learn basic topics from scratch or just to enhance your problem-solving skill, they got you covered with in-depth lessons. You can learn important concepts such as factors. You will master the basics of factors operations, and understanding factors can help you visualize and solve complex problems in multidimensional spaces. This is the kind of learning resource that I wish to have when I was in high school. So I'm recommending it to you. Now you can even try Brilliant for free for 30 days. Use the link in the description, brilliant.org/blackpenredpen, and you can also get 20% off discount. I want to thank Brilliant for sponsoring this video, and I also want to thank you guys for checking out.